Please be seated. Good morning, and welcome to Bentley University. My name is Iris Berdrow, and I will serve as today's ceremonial marshal. Before we proceed, I'd like to remind our guests that should you prefer an indoor location at any time, today's event will be live streamed in the Dana Center, which is the building to my left, and in the Bentley Arena. Now it is my pleasure to call to the lectern the chair of Bentley's Board of Trustees, Paul Condren, member of the class of 1983 and a parent of children from the classes of 2019 and 2022.
Good morning. It is my honor to call to order the 104th undergraduate commencement exercises at Bentley University. On behalf of the Board of Trustees, administration, faculty, and staff, we are gathered here to recognize and celebrate the accomplishments of the class of 2023 and welcome them as the newest members of the proud Bentley alumni family. In this morning's academic procession, we are pleased to be joined by the alumni leaders of the Global Alumni Board and the Blue and Gold Society, which recognizes alumni who have graduated 50 years ago or more. This includes alumni from the class of 1973 who are proudly celebrating their 50th reunion this weekend. Class of 2023, Bentley is excited to celebrate you today, and we hope you will plan to join us again at commencement in 2073 for your 50th reunion. Class of 2023, on making it to this day, we know you will make us proud, and we look forward to seeing all that you accomplish.
Thank you, Chair Condren. Now, if able, please rise for the invocation and remain standing for a performance of America the Beautiful by a member of the class of 2023, Elizabeth DeFilippis. I call to the lectern Reverend Dr. Robin J. Olson, Director of the Spiritual Life Center at Bentley University, to offer this morning's invocation.
Bentley beloved, I offer you greetings from a 14th century saint named Julian of Norwich, credited as the first woman to write a book in English. Julian lived during a global pandemic in her time called the Black Plague, and she wrote these words of existential hope for her time and for ours. And Julian wrote, "All shall be well. All manner of things shall be well, for there is a force of love moving through the universe that holds us fast and will never let us go." Bentley, beloved community, on this glorious day where long-held dreams are released into the beauty of accomplishment, we come together to give thanks, for all shall be well. There is a force for good calling us to celebrate today. We are a diverse community. Look around at this gorgeous array representing a variety of spiritual and religious and ethical traditions. And so I invite you right now, in this moment, to be mindful of all that is holy for you. To inhale deeply and to exhale, helping you to be present in this moment right now of glory and accomplishment. In that same spirit of universal breath and particular practice, at the end of the prayer, We will be in a moment of silence so each can conclude in accord with their own tradition or movement of the heart. And now, class of 2023 and this beautiful array, will you join me in prayer and reflection? Gracious force of love moving through the universe, still small voice of our hearts. We give praise on this day of celebration as we rejoice in the accomplishments of our graduating students of the class of 2023. We give thanks for the knowledge they have gained, for the challenges they have overcome, and for the quality of the character they have forged. We are grateful for profound friendships made in dorm rooms, in classrooms, and boardrooms. We offer thanks for the expertise and wisdom of faculty and staff who have taught and mentored our amazing students. We are grateful for the vision of President Crite and his administration, declaring the intersection of business ethics and social impact as a force for good. As people who have come this far by the faith of our families and our friends, we humbly say thank you to them for loving us so well. They never stopped telling us all shall be well. All shall be well. And we are grateful for their belief in us. Even now, we remember those champions in our lives who have passed away. And with gratitude, we name them silently before you. We remember. And we give thanks for all those who have crossed our paths in the force of love, holding us fast in service. We give thanks for Bentley essential beloveds who kept us safe, who cared for our health, who fed us meals, who cleaned our buildings, who mowed our lawns, who tended our spirits. Finally, loving spirit, as our graduates receive their diplomas today, ignite within them a passion to share their gifts for the healing and harmony of this world. Send them forth in the force of your love as they step bravely into the future with compassion and purpose. In the name of all we call holy, we give thanks, each in our own way. And the bird song of all of creation joins us as we say amen. All shall be well, friends. All shall be well. Amen.
Oh, boy. Hello, everybody. Oh, beautiful for spacious skies, for amber waves of grain, for purple mountain majesties above the fruited plain. America, America, God shed his grace on thee and crowned thy good with brotherhood from sea to shining sea. Oh, beautiful for heroes proved in liberating strife, who more than self their country loved, and mercy more than life. America, America, may God thy gold refine, till success be nobleness and every gain divine.
You may be seated. I call to the lectern the class of 2023, Senior Class President Elisa Gaeta, to welcome her fellow graduates.
Good morning, families, friends, faculty, staff, notable guests, trustees, President Kreit, and most of all, the undergraduate class of 2023. I'm honored to be standing here in front of all of you representing the 2023 graduates as a senior class president. During my junior year of high school, I spent every waking moment working towards the goal of being valedictorian. I focused on the anxiety of accomplishment, and it prevented me from enjoying my life in the moment. I sacrificed spending time with friends, making memories with my family, and truly enjoying practicing with my sports teams. I was so fixated on being valedictorian that I neglected building relationships and making memories that would last a lifetime. When it was announced I was going to be valedictorian, I felt fulfilled for about 45 seconds, but then came the 46th second. I felt nothing. The happiness began to fade. I realized in those seconds that there were lessons to learn and could apply to my time at Bentley. I knew it would be important to develop deep, sustainable relationships, find balance in every aspect of my life, and live in the present. The difference between then and now is that I'm learning this lesson, and I have made an effort to spend time creating balance in my life. I ask you all to look to your left and to your right. Do you know the people sitting near you? Look around you and in the bleachers. Are there people you see that you want to stay connected with in your post-graduation life? I promised myself when I joined Bentley's community that I would not just focus on the quantity of people I would meet to build my network, but I would develop the quality of each relationship. How should we evaluate the quality of our relationships? Are these the people that we can turn to when we need something or can picture as members of our wedding parties? While it's ingrained in us to build our LinkedIn network and meet as many people as possible, it's also important to invest time with people we enjoy. Life is short. Be with people who make us feel good about ourselves and reciprocate our investment. Bentley has taught me the importance of striking a balance in life. And the lesson is something I want to implement moving forward. There needs to be a balance between work and play. Ask yourself, where should you invest your time? Do you solely focus on work, so much so that you can't enjoy any leisure time? Do you spend so much social time with people that you lose sight of your work goals? While many of us probably struggled with this balance over the past few years, I'm continuing to learn that it's important to find balance. And to do so, it's important to live in the present. The present is all that we have. The present is all that we are guaranteed. We can no longer affect the past, nor can we control or worry about the future. While focusing on the present is definitely a struggle for me, and probably for most of us, it's all a learning process. Seizing the moment and making the most of what we are doing is essential. Give your all to the moment that you are living in, because that will create happiness and memories that will last forever. As we look to embark on the next phase of our journey, we are leaving here with knowledge and a variety of accomplishments. We can all confidently walk away from Bentley equipped to succeed in business, but we are also equipped to take on much more that life has in store for us. Over the past few years, we have all started to learn how to lead a life of sustainable joy. We all had to make decisions about what our future may look like. Now is the time to apply that learning. To quote Arianna Huffington, co-founder of the Huffington Post and founder and CEO of Thrive Global, "We think, mistakenly, that success is the result of the amount of time we put in at work instead of the quality of time we put in. My wish for us all is that we succeed, that we live a life of sustainable joy, and that we recognize that the quality of our life can be measured by the balance that we bring to it. My final request before we graduate today is that we take the time to speak with those that surround us and remain connected with those who mean the most to us at Bentley. Thank you, and once again, congratulations to the class of 2023. I am so proud of all of us and what we have accomplished. Thank you."
Thank you, Alyssa. I now call to the lectern the ninth president of Bentley University, E. LeBrent Crite, to address the graduates.
Esteemed honoree Charlie Baker, members of the Board of Trustees, faculty and staff, distinguished guests, families, and friends, on behalf of the entire Bentley community, thank you for joining us for this very special day, the 104th undergraduate commencement exercises at Bentley University. We are honored to have you here with us. And to the class of 2023, congratulations on reaching this long-awaited and enormously well-earned milestone. Since you first gathered as a class 4 years ago, getting to this moment was your collective goal. Today is the culmination and the celebration of your years of hard work. And as we all know, you did not get to this day alone. You are here, in part anyway, thanks to the unwavering support of so many. Please do take a moment to join me in thanking your friends and colleagues, but most especially your families for their support and guidance throughout your academic journey here at Bentley University. As you prepare to turn the page on that journey before beginning an exciting new chapter, you would be well served to take a moment to recognize just how momentous this occasion is. Your class is one which endured uncertainty and countless challenges, not the least of which was a global black swan event. Just as you were settling into your first year as a college student, the world turned upside down. You were required to adapt to new ways than any other class in the history of our university. In adapting to this new normal, you demonstrated your capacity to withstand the harsh and inevitable blows of any challenges that will come your way. And this is a good thing. After all, the economic marketplace and the broader society in which you will enter is largely defined by exponential change. Emergent and ubiquitous technologies will continue to disrupt how we work and interact, and the chasms across our society seem unlikely to dissipate anytime soon. Despite the changes and uncertainties, I remain hopeful in our collective futures because I remain inspired by the communities of young adults like you who will soon assume the mantle of leadership, and who have not lost the capacity to be outraged by unfairness and injustice. You have continuously shown that you are equipped with the skills and abilities, fluencies, the worldview to overcome any challenges that you will face. You have an opportunity here this very moment to begin making your mark and having a positive impact on society. That potential to make substantive changes is why I believe so strongly in this academic community and in the role of business in our society. I came to Bentley because I believe in the power of capitalism and the power of business. And because a Bentley education goes beyond the traditional view of capitalism and its allocative economic efficiencies, and instead focuses on the power of business to impact the human condition. I also came to Bentley because we have no interest in educating the mind at the expense of the heart. Mostly, I was attracted to Bentley because of my belief in you and your ability to go out and make a positive and lasting difference in this world. You have proven that you are up to the task, and you should be proud of how you have succeeded in the face of profound adversity. I speak for each professor, staff member, and administrator at this university when I say that Bentley is proud to have had you as a member of our community. Our hope is that while you were here, you realized the transformational possibilities that can result from sustained exposure to differing points of view. We have intentionally exposed you to ideas and experiences that will enable you to discern between what is right and what is easy, and to recognize that with the privilege of the education you've just received comes a responsibility to a greater good. I know that you are ready to make your impact on the world, and I await in great anticipation to see how you will do so. So before I conclude, I'd like to leave you with one parting piece of advice, which I hope you'll be able to, at least on occasion, reflect. As you begin this next stage of your journey, I appreciate that you will be focused on attaining the right job at the right salary, so that they can ensure that you have the right income, as these are often salient in the pursuit of our happiness and success. And there is nothing wrong with this, but I would ask you to perhaps focus less directly on seeking happiness and success and focus more on the pursuit of meaning and purpose in your lives. Because once you identify meaning, your own true north, I can assure you that happiness and success will follow. And more critically, it will endure. Class of 2023, I hope that as you transition from Bentley, that you will continue to identify and stay true to your own true north. As you do, know that we are endlessly proud of each of you and will watch with great anticipation to see the powerful impact you have and on the amazing things you will achieve. Congratulations and enjoy your day.
Thank you, President Kreit. I now call to the lectern Chair Condren to confer this morning's honorary degree to Charles D. Baker.
Charlie Baker, architect of solutions and compromise, advocate for technology and innovation, we are proud to confer upon you today the honorary degree, Doctor of Commercial Science. Complex, significant challenges are your specialty. In 1999, Harvard Pilgrim Healthcare was approaching bankruptcy when you stepped up as president and CEO. Your talent for thoughtful but decisive action led the organization back to profitability. The ability to find common ground with healthcare leaders would continue to serve you well. As executive in residence at General Catalyst Partners, you are a valuable resource for mission-driven companies, a champion for responsible innovations, and trusted partner in their work to make the world a better place. Over two terms as governor of Massachusetts, you became the most popular governor in the nation. And we credit the accolades to your get it done mantra, which always puts progress above partisanship. With respectful nods to innovation and technology, you also knew the best tool for any job was listening. These qualities were essential in leading the Commonwealth for 8 years, particularly as data and viewpoints raged throughout the COVID-19 pandemic. But the pandemic did not singularly define your years on Beacon Hill. The record will reflect significant investments in K-12 education, eliminating the budget deficit while cutting taxes, and forwarding the Commonwealth's commitment to renewable energy to control climate change. Today, as president of the NCAA, you stand on a campus where sports at every level are a force for building skills, pride, and community. And we stand with you on the work ahead. That is, to preserve the tremendous opportunity that athletics presents while protecting the safety and rights of our players. You assess the challenge with typical refreshing simplicity. We have to figure it out. Know that we have every confidence, Charlie, that you will. Therefore, by the virtue of the authority vested by the Commonwealth of Massachusetts and by the Bentley University Board of Trustees, we confer upon you, Charles D. Baker, the degree Doctor of Commercial Science, honoris causa. We hold it both an honor and a pleasure to do so.
I now call Charles D. Baker to deliver the commencement address.
Good morning. Jesus, that's loud. I want to thank you all very much for being given this opportunity to speak today. But before I begin, I want to take a special moment to congratulate the class of 2023. You entered Bentley in the fall of 2019. And honestly, I hope your college experience is one that will never be repeated. Your discipline, creativity, resilience, kindness, and grace were all put to the test time and time again. And your success and your presence here today proves beyond any reasonable doubt that you are an exceptional group of young people. Now, I've been to 3 of my own graduations, high school, college, and graduate school. I have no idea who spoke at my high school graduation. I remember the German Chancellor Helmut Kohl spoke at my college graduation, but I don't recall anything about what he said. And General Motors CEO Roger Smith spoke at my business school graduation. I have no idea what he said either. So I'm starting from a place where I recognize the extremely high bar I have to climb over here today to say anything that you might recall. So let me start with this. Your lives will continue to be filled with choices and challenges. The choices you make will play a big role in the challenges, especially the ones you face and how you handle them. So first, please, and I know I speak for every parent in the place, do try to make good choices. Second, and you're going to hear this and my third point for the second time, and none of us coordinated around this. Second, be a good listener. You learn more when you listen, even if you don't always want to hear what's being said. And that, by the way, will also help you with that whole make good choices thing. Third, appreciate that life is a team sport and that purpose usually comes from shared commitments. Again, that one will also help you with, number one, make good choices. With respect to the choices you'll be making, let me tell you a story. No one would have ever expected that my grandmother and grandfather would have chosen one another. They met on an airfield in France during World War I. She was with the Red Cross, and he was a National Guardsman. She was from Massachusetts and a graduate of Smith College, and he was from New York City and never went to college. But they made a connection, and after the war, they wrote to each other. Not emails, not texts, not phone calls, no picture sharing. They simply wrote letters for months. After a while, he wrote to her and asked her to marry him. She wrote back and said, no. Obviously, he was crushed. It turned out that her mom and dad were not wild about their daughter marrying some stranger from New York City, probably a Yankees fan, who didn't have much of a life story or the resources to come visit and ask for her hand in person. These were all good points in the 1920s. But the more she thought about it, the more she thought he was the one for her, and she did something that was a bit shocking at that time. She ignored her parents, she wrote back to my grandfather, and she asked him if the proposal was still on the table. He said it was. They got married and they settled just outside New York City, where he was working first as a salesman and then eventually as a director of personnel at a men's clothing store. They raised three children, and my grandmother spent countless hours volunteering for the Red Cross and substitute teaching. Life was good. Through a series of unfortunate events, my grandfather lost his sight in his mid-60s, and then he became pretty physically disabled. My grandmother couldn't take care of him by herself, so they moved back to her hometown in Newburyport, where she had tons of family and a lot of support. As kids, we spent hours and hours with them, and in fact, my grandfather taught me how to love the Red Sox. He used to listen to every game on a battery-powered transistor radio, and I would sit with him, soaking in the sounds of the ballpark behind the chatter of the commentators. Now, listening to a baseball game with someone who's blind is completely different than listening to it with someone who can see. He never got distracted. He was totally focused on what he could hear. And the sounds coming out of that radio filled the small living room we sat in on game days to the brim. Honestly, to this day, I thought it was one of the most amazing experiences of my life. Now, my grandmother was also one of the smartest people I've ever met. When I was in high school, I asked one of my history teachers if she could come guest lecture. He said, okay. She came in, stood in front of the class, and started her remarks by saying, my grandfather was born before George Washington died. And then she was off. A personalized, interactive discussion of U.S. history woven together with direct connections between historical events and family folklore. My classmates couldn't get enough of it. Now, my grandfather died in 1971, 1 year before their 50th wedding anniversary, and my grandmother died in 1982 at the age of 96. I tell you their story because they made an unusual choice. They chose each other. They were an odd couple for their time. They never had much money, but they built a purposeful and beautiful life. They had big challenges, but they played the hand they were dealt with kindness and optimism, and they played it together. That's important. Every hand will come with surprises and disappointment. Yours will too. Who will play that hand with you? It's one of the biggest and the most important choices of all that you'll make. Now, second, be a good listener. I'll tell you another story. When I ran for governor the first time in 2010 and lost to former Governor Deval Patrick, that hurt. And in fact, I was still pretty sore when a young man called me up and said he was organizing the first robotics competition at the Agganis Arena at Boston University. He asked me if I would come speak to the teams that were participating in the contest to kick off the morning. I paused for a minute, picked the phone back up, and said, "Hey, you know, I just lost the election. Why do you want me to come speak?" There was a brief pause, and then he said, "I think you're perfect. I want you to come tell the kids about why it's okay to fail." My first thought was he was very lucky he wasn't standing in front of me. My second was to hang up on him, but I'd been raised by my parents to hear people out, and I heard him out, and in time, I thought the story he was asking me to share was a good one. So I went, and I told it, and to this day, I still run into people who were there who tell me they were glad that I did. This whole thing about listening, which several people have talked about, it's real. My mom was a Democrat. My dad, who's now 94, is a Republican. And as far as I can tell, they canceled each other out in virtually every election, even though they were happily married for 60 years. And when I asked my mom in 2010, which was the last election she was involved in, if she voted for me, I said, "Hey, this is going to be like the first time, you know, family's on the same side, da-da-da-da-da." And my mom said, "You know, it's a secret ballot, son." She didn't like my campaign. A lot of people didn't. I wish she'd been around for 14. But growing up, the dinner table at our house was a constant conversation. I literally had friends who would lobby to come over and just watch. Nobody's motives or characters were questioned when my mom and dad would go back and forth on the issues of the day. Nobody threw anything. But people had plenty of opinions. There was only one rule. You had to listen more than you spoke. And when you spoke, you had to demonstrate some appreciation for what the other person was saying. In my mom and dad's house, being part of the team meant appreciating more points of view than just your own and demonstrating it respectfully on a regular basis. They were great partners to each other and to those around them. And as my mom always said to me when I was young, "You know, you have two ears and one mouth for a reason." So be a good listener. You'll learn, you'll grow, and you just may marry someone who doesn't always agree with you, and that will be okay. Finally, and I swear the president and I did not communicate on this, find purpose. There's a lot of talk about happiness these days. I think happiness is fleeting. And chasing it misses the bigger picture. What really matters and what sustains happiness is purpose. Purpose comes with being in it, whatever it might be, with people you care about and who care about you. Marriage, friendship, work, community service, play, child raising, coaching, teaching, cheering, volunteering, figuring something out. Note that I didn't mention politics. I found tremendous purpose in public service, but it pales compared to 35 years of marriage, 3 children, and the neighbors and friends who bucked us up for years before I did anything in government and have been there to do the same throughout my time in office and beyond. I'm 66 years old. That's 787 months and 23,912 days. That's a lot of mileage. I've had good days and bad ones, good months and bad ones, good years and bad ones. But honestly, that's really not what I remember. What I remember and what I cherish most of all are the people I've had a chance to share my time with, the relationships I've been able to develop, and how those people have made me feel. I've tried desperately hard not to let them down, to be there for them, and to set a good example. My dad always felt he won the lottery when he met and married my mom. And while he hated the Alzheimer's disease that ruined the last 10 years of her life, he found joy in caring for her when she got sick. because that gave him purpose. Make good choices, be a good listener, appreciate that life's a team sport, and find purpose in the things you choose to do. Yes, those are cliches. However, that doesn't make them wrong. It just makes them, like me, old. Let me close with this. When my daughter graduated from college just before the pandemic, I wrote her a letter. Here's part of it. Every life is about choices and challenges. You choose your friends, you choose your path, you choose your attitude. Over and over and over again, you will choose. The challenges, whatever they may be, will be there no matter what choices you make. But the choices you make can determine the kinds of challenges you face and the arsenal of support and guidance that will be there to see you through them. Don't fear challenges and disappointments. Growth is often about getting comfortable with being uncomfortable and learning from difficult moments. My life's journey has had many disappointments, but I learned from those experiences, and I had your mom and my network of friends and colleagues to help me see my way through it. I love you, Dad. I wish all of you well. Believe it or not, your graduation is actually just the end of the beginning. The next chapter, well, that one belongs to you. So try to make good choices, listen, the world will be calling, and find great partners to make your world a better place. Good luck, congratulations, and God bless.
Thank you, Mr. Baker. I call to the lectern, Provost and Vice President for Academic Affairs, Paul Teslick, to offer congratulations on behalf of the faculty and to announce the 2023 Faculty Awards.
Greetings and congratulations, Class of 2023. I'm honored to be with you this morning as we celebrate the completion of this portion of your academic journey, which has been years in the making. You've accomplished a great deal in your time at Bentley. Our dedicated faculty of teacher scholars have so enjoyed helping you achieve your goals and supporting your journey to this special day. Would all the members of Bentley University faculty please stand if you're able so that we can express our appreciation for all your outstanding efforts? I'm pleased to share that four of our talented faculty were recently honored for their academic excellence and dedication to our students. We celebrate their achievements this morning, along with yours. The Gregory H. Adamian Award for Excellence in Teaching was presented to Zarina Prater, Associate Professor in English and Media Studies, and Barbara Nash, Adjunct Professor in Natural and Applied Sciences. We are also proud to recognize outstanding scholarship by our faculty. The 2023 Bentley University Award for Excellence in Scholarship was presented to Pierre Berthon, Professor of Information Design and Corporate Communication, and the Clifford Yauss Chair of Information Design, Marketing, and Strategy. Finally, the Joseph M. Cronin Award for Excellence in Academic Advising and Mentoring was presented to James Poliopoulos, Senior Lecturer in Marketing. Poli, we see you out there. These outstanding faculty represent just a small sample of the world-class talent at Bentley. We are pleased and proud to recognize these award winners this morning and thank all of our faculty for their contributions to the Bentley community.
I call upon Provost Teslick to present the candidates for graduation and to preside over the awarding of degrees.
During today's ceremony, we acknowledge the deserving undergraduate students who have fulfilled their degree requirements. You have demonstrated the ability and determination to claim the academic recognition you so richly deserve. As you cross the stage, you will join a community of 67,000 Bentley alumni who have gone on to achieve incredible things, using their education to change and influence the world for the better and leave a positive impact everywhere they go. That is a responsibility you now bear as well. It is our expectation and hope that you will go forth for a force for good in this world that's so desperately in need of you and your considerable skills and character. At this time, I ask President Kreit to join me as we announce the graduates from Bentley University's class of 2023.
To expedite these proceedings, please hold your applause until the names of all the candidates have been read. For everyone's security and comfort, please keep the aisles clear and do not approach the stage to take pictures as it blocks the view for others. A reminder that a professional photographer is taking pictures of each graduate as they walk across the stage. Finally, out of respect for all graduates and your classmates, we ask all to remain seated until the last graduate's name is read.
David Zachary Daniels. Alyssa Nicole Gaeta. Chanel Reagan Gerla.
Kritin Anup Haley O'Connor. Robert John Oliarchik Jr. Benjamin Jeffrey Walker. Hannah Madison Charouz. Rachel Corinne Zumberg. Shikali Alizada. Ramiro Aguirre. Scott James Aniser. Grace Elizabeth Bennett. Lindsay Muriel Blaze. Cassie Rose Butch. Jack Peter Campbell. Henry Lawrence Casassa. Javon Dean Richard Falder. Azure Lace Cook. Emily Danelian. Anna Maria Dos Santos Becker. Close this program, open it back. Liam Michael Drobny. Samantha Duong. Alexander Joseph Fayen. Emily Elizabeth Foltan. Catherine Ford. Keely Christine Frazier. Annelle Gallenbeck.
The primary will be coming soon.
Melissa Ann Gallagher. Jacob William Gabel. Mavis Gahn. William Greco. Vicente Paul Ibanez. Adam Russell Cassatley. Valerie Ann Kilroy. Kimaya Foro Kim. Amy Genevieve Knieven. Alexi Kolashak. Christina Tsu-Er Lee. Thomas Lee. Victor Wei Liu. Victoria Lukey. Emma Mangino. Mason David Matos. Nick Mamus. Aiden McBride. Simone Medina Para. Teresa Mercado Pichardo. Katie Grace Mill. Anthony Salvatore Maluzzo. Jaden Andrew Mullen. John Murphy. Jem Urshamer. Justine Palencia. Andrew David Quagaroli. Laura Elisa Rodriguez Vela. Paula Rojas Castellanos. Sabrina W. Sam. Celia Claire Skirman. Carice Siebersad. Debian Sen. Zihan Evelyn Song. Jake Ryan Tarantino. Leticia Usberti Elias. Bryce Cody Valier. Samantha Rochelle Van Gestel. Brendan Van. Christopher Ross Ward Willis. James Harris Wilson. Megan Elizabeth Winslow. Jack Aronson. Julia Rose Bone. Anthony Paul Duong. Ian Mail. Liam McClellan. Corinne Arlene Messier. Coleman Lee Shea. Caroline Marie Zatkowski. Zachary Joseph Aaron. Olivia Elizabeth Rossetti. Julia Abraham. Andrew Edward Acuna. Marissa Ann Adamo. Ilika Ariel Madonna Adams. S- Sultan Ayomide Adebisi. Nev A. Adler. Javin Kumar Agarwal. Michael John Akerson. Oluwatoyesi Temidayo Akindoli. Michaela Albert. Sarah Alex. Matthew Alanji. Salman Mohammed Al-Jomai. Hind Al-Katrash. Alexander El-Mosni. Ghanima Al-Kabandi. Suleiman Al-Kudibi. Hamid Abdulrahman Al-Tuwajiri. Anna Catherine Alves. Damian Joseph Amanti. Jake Alexander Amel. Angelo Todd Amodeo. Hallie Swaychon Anderson. Jerry Rocco Andriotola. Caroline Alita Andrews. Colin Sebastian Andrews. Juan Emilio Araujo. Daniel Arbel. Tug Arnold. Hannah Gloria Aronowitz. Sara Ariola Peak. Kwaku Ashiabor. Alexia Asaf. David Fernando Atala Faraj. Rohan Atreya. Jenna Addis. Samuel Wyatt Aubie. Caroline Elizabeth Offiero. Amid Al-Aziz. Namuna Batar. Joseph Louis Balboni. Sasha Balchenkov. Bethany Isabel Aquino Barber. Adesola Bamigbaye. David Brady Berry. Luke Thomas Barreto. Alpha A. Berry. Ryan Thomas Barkowitz. June Barton. Noah Bass. Rebecca Jane Bauer. Victoria Lauren Beaton. Edward Beauregard Jr. Matthew David Beeser. Strat Becker. Jake Philip Bedell. Lauren Jacqueline Belair. Salomon Henry Benassareff. Luis Benedicto Reyes. Luca Manuel Bennett Rodriguez. Rochelle J. Benjamin. Taryn Alexa Bennett. Abigail Benware. Haley Isabel Bernhardt. Ava Marie Bevilacqua.
Ryan A. Bay.
Chirag Bambani. Quinn Alexander Bittinger Esser. Graydon Black. Jake Sullivan Blatler. Owen Blake. Matthew Edward Bloom. Amelia Mary Blum. William Jeffrey Blumen. Kellen Mac Bohenick. Evan Charles Bolton. Daniel Michael Bond. Blake Charles Bondelio. Patrick Barella. Miles Joseph Borenstein. Robinson Bo Hernandez. Isaiah Bottesini. Haley A. Bourgeois. Joseph Gerard Bouchel. Kyle Robert Brady. Kennedy Pratt Brake. Lucas Baldwin Brayman. Pedro Enrique Bronco Giavin. Andrew John Bremser. Corey James Bright. Alexis Brinkman. Matthew William Brittingham. Julia P. Brockney. Colton Brown. Harrison Brew. Emily Burnham. Adam Burns. David Michael Burris Mendoza. Declan Butler. Sadie Fu Ann Kasha. Justin Cagno. Frank Hollis Caldwell. Caitlin Mackenzie Cameron. Jose Guadalupe Campa. Jason Kaplan. Brian Thomas Cardarelli. Jack Ryan Carney. Alyssa Marie Carolyn. Martin Paul Del Rosario Carpio. Shane Peter Carr. Nicholas V. Carson. Anna Gabriella Carter. Ryan Patrick Cartwright. Eduardo Jose Casalduc Soltero. William Case. Nicole Castelblanco. Fallon Caturo. Ashley Brianna Catogio. Andrew Haskell Cavanaugh. Sergio Chalella. Aaron Chan. Nicholas Chang. Nathan Benzion Atia. Tricia Victoria Matuti Diaz. Simka Tizmineski Soler. Isabel Bueno Losada. Isabella de Jesus Ochoa Quezada. Daniela Kudari. Sara Rosas Ruiz. Isabella Castillo Corrales. Crystal Chow. Estefania Chavera. Ashley Chen. Carmen Chen. Jennifer Chen. Simon Chen. Yanlin Chen. Tai Yi Cheng. Wei Ching Chi. Kai Wen Kevin Chiang. Stephanie Marie Chasen.
Gian Alberto Chiavari.
Zachary Aaron Chin. Zoe Kathleen Chin. Audrey Elizabeth Christo. Nicholas Tyler Christopher. Aaron Chung. Alexandra Sabiniak. Mark Sinati. Grayson Kane Clark. Madison J. Clark. Angela Marie Caggiano. Adam Hollis Clark. Owen Douglas Cobb. Weston Reed Cohen. Alexander Michael Colella. Kevin Coles. Thomas Michael Connaughton. Shane Thomas Conroy. Jane Catherine Conry. Miruna Iwana Constantine. Anna Beatriz Constantino. Michael Jaden Cooper. Matthew Robert Carreri. Jose Cortez. Bridget Kelly Coughlin. Kyle Stewart Cool. Autumn R. Coulthard. Nicholas Emmanuel Kutrakos. Matthew Nabi Crapo. Connor William Cruz. Horacio Cruz Mendoza. J.T. Culp. Allison Marie Curcio. Joseph James Curran. Corinna Isabel Curtis. Lauren Elizabeth Dachowski. Rhea Bunkum Dalal, Victor D'Angelo, T. Dow, Carter William Davis, Dagmawi Getachew Dawit, Mohammed Daib, Devani Estella De La Garza, Benjamin F. Deckhut, Jack Timothy Dean, Anne Mae DeForge, Vincent Gianni Del Signori, Jack Barry Delahunt, Robert DeMarco, Jennifer F. DeMello, Haley Demetris, Jingbin Dang, Dominic Michael DePauli, Liz DeFilippis, Zarifa DeShong, John Eusebio DeStepanis, Leia DeVoe, Kumudini Devala, John Shane Morrison Devine, Thomas William Devlin, Asim Darshi, Mia Therese DiBiasio, Corbinian Dietrich, Norayer DeLoyen, Brenda Dishani, Hannah Linnea Denellen, Rachel Elizabeth Denellen, Ryan Richard Donovan, Samantha Hope Dording, Peter Lee Dorialan, Joseph Michael Dusso, Kayla Douglas, Megan Elizabeth Douglas, Jack Davidson Dretler, Carly Paige Drischler, Jamie Drucker, Mia Elizabeth Drumheller, Shu Han Duan, Patrick Victor Afa, Tanner Dean Eisenhut, Noah Ayinde Elebede.
Jobin Ilian.
Elizabeth Elliott. Morgan Elizabeth Ennis. Nicole Stephanie Erdekian. Antonio Espinosa Moreno. Elizabeth Jean Estep. Crystalie Amelie Etienne. Katarina Exarchos. Daniel James Fantasia, Juan Diego Fara, Cameron Palmer Farah, Julia Ferry, Nadim Oliver Faisal, Matthew Jonathan Fiore, Thomas Joseph Fisher Jr., Jack McHale Flaherty, Sean Mikhail Flanagan, Jackson Edwin Flanders, Julia Elizabeth Flood, Giselle Flores, Jack Flores Dominguez, Robert Flynn, Kayla Foley. Abdullah Ihab Fode. Adam Robert Francis. Duncan Richard Fraser. Daniel Jonathan Friedman. Jen Fu. Matthew Donald Furch. Yona Gagani. Joseph Christopher Galante. Eduardo Alejandro Galindez. Kayla Monique Gallegos. Catherine Galvin. William Gao. Noah Garcia. Ramiro Jose Garcia. Alexis Garcia Busa. Paisley Jolene Gardner. John Michael Davis Garofano. Aiden J. Jera. Kelly Gurdon. Timothy Edward Giromini. Andrew Nicolas Gimpetanu. Dominic Michael Gianetto. John Robert Jaquinto. Parker James Gooden. Kayla Nicole Gilbert. Kyle Robert Gilbert. Victor Galinsky. Brianna Lynn Gillen.
Yo, heat in four.
Daniel P. Gillis. Isabel Olivia Gillis. Gianmarco Hinorio. Caitlin Rose Jambetti. Jacob Goldstein. Jacqueline Gomes D'Souza. Anifern Gonzalez Brache. Antonio Alejandro Gonzalez Dorazio. Mateusz Albert Goszewski. Morgan Elizabeth Gavoni. Matthew Graham. Benjamin Robert Gramling. Andrew Murray Granzier. Hannah Elizabeth Green. Elizabeth Gruel. Nathan Griffith. Madeline Jane Grube. Zhao Guan. Jose Raul Guardiola Aranda. Christina L. Famia Figueroa. Mark Robert Guerra. Michaela Guerrero. Hiran Gugnani. Angela R. Guidera de Groot. Selena Guo. Somia V. Desai. Rina Nisha Gupta. Casey Marie Gustafson. Abby Gustafson. Marco Domenico Hagler Manfredi. Christopher Charles Hagedorn. Cooper Thomas Haggerty. Ethan Neil Harrison. Sana Fatima Haji. Madison Kathleen Hallis. Michael Henry Hall. Rachel Elizabeth Hall. Francesca Maria Halloran, Garrett Hammer, Dakota Smith Handley, Donovan Lee Harvey, Risa Hada, Avery Simon Hines, Benjamin Ronald Helen, Alan Henderson, Sebastian Dale Henshaw, Daniela Herrera Gutierrez, Catherine Hopkins Heslink, Grace Caroline Hesterberg, Anna Bloxham Higgins, Andrea Ilsaca Fernandez, Abigail Hirsch, Ahmed Hamina, Aiden Hopkins, Brian Francis Houle, Joseph George Haushin Jr., Tina Huang, Young Na Huang, Julia Babette Halton, Mary R. Huminsky, Juliana Yavarone Torres, Aiden Ignatius, Carlos Igina Cruz, Christos Ioannidis, Spencer P. Irving, Renato Manuel Isayere Roca, Luke T. Jabber, Aiden Joseph Jackaleff, Dylan Sean Jenkins, James Edward Johnson, Jessica Ann Johnson, Michaela Sky Johnson, Graham Taylor Johnstone, Anna Elizabeth Jones, Brooke Christine Jones, Dylan Michael Jones, Catherine Lee Jones, Christopher George Jorgensen, Prosky Joseph,
Vishwa Kandarp Joshi,
Anthony Cadalio, Alexander Dimitrios Kalajaropoulos, Ayat Karimsak, Demi Katinas, Stephen Romero Kauvaka, Emily Margaret Keys, Harrison L. Kelly, Tara Marie Kelly, Gavin Ferguson Kelly, Patrick James Kelly, Emily Kern, Lindsay Kerrigan, Fatima N. Khalid, Tomas Pinheiro Hahn, Moises Capel Mizrachi, Tabby Kiatanant, Alex Kim, Alexa June Kim, Jason Kim, Isabella Mallory King, Eben Daniel Kinsella, William James Kleisler III, Benjamin Francis Klingler, Alexander Koch, George Christos Komboris, Richard Kong, Athena Constantinidis. Avant Kothari. Alexander John Koutsis. Emiliano Rafael Cresser Perez. Eric Daniel Krugliak. Neil Raj Kumar. Nathan James Kamu. Burrell Joan Kasuma. Bryce Isaac Cooter. Bradley Richard Labadini. Lachlan Michael Lacoste. Jonathan Bruce Leidenheim. Caroline Grace Lafoe. Alexander Jason Lambert. Riley Philip Lambert. Jeffrey Thomas Lamoth. Michael Eugene Lamoureux. Ryan Edward Landolfi. Daniel William Langlois. Nathaniel Larkins. Emily Ann LaRosa. Alejandro La Torraca Montalvo. Christopher Alexander Lara. Jessica Marie Lay. Jacob Leibowitz. Alton Leitzai. Christopher Lee. Samantha Louise Lee. Ryan Jeffrey Leiby. Dylan Mark Layton. Ryan Patrick Lentall. Andrew Thomas Leo Grande. Patrick Leonard. Carter Edward Latalian. Fisher Elias Leviser. Luis Alexandre Levesque. Evan Levine. Elizabeth Nicole Levis. Leandrew LeBron Contreras. Dong Xiao Li. Jason Lee. Yi Hong Lee. Sydney Amber Lian. Jasmine Lin. Jessica Lin. Jiahao Lin. Yue Yue Ling. Max Lindner. Eric Linnell. Edwin Liriano Ramirez. Singy M. Lim. Jun Qing Eddie Liu. Shu Chen Liu. Ashlyn Maria Lacoco. Arjun Kishan Loke. Ryan Looney. Abel A. Lopes, Jr. George Murphy Lord. Massimo Lorenzetti. Gregory Scott Lothrop. Tyler Gary Lewis. Samantha Lovering. Sophia Catherine Lucier. Samantha Grace Lucero. Davin Christopher Liu. Alexander Lunetta. Salvatore Nicholas Lupoli Jr. Mackenzie Taylor Lupton. Kevin Tree Liu. Kevin Dean Lynch. Sydney Lauren Lynch. Timothy Joseph Lynch. Mark Lysakowski. Colin Douglas McDonald. Julia Michelle MacIsaac. Alexis Nicole Mack. Brody Donald McLean. Travis Lee McPhail. Bridget Louise Marr. Eric George Makatadze. Soleil Maldonado Perez. William J. Malone. Rohit Mangtani. V. Mai. Rihanna Maniar. Kaylee Grace Mankins. Evan William Mankowski. Monica Elizabeth Manna. Joyce Mao. Austin Gary Marinosi. Yu Tong Li. Xing Yao Lu. Anthony M. Marmo. Samantha May Martell. Isaac Martin. Roberto Martins de Andrade Curry. Connor Bradford Mason. Lindsay Barbara Masarski. Maxwell Michael Matarazzo. Matsky Mathy. Alex Daniel Madison. Ryan McBride. Lindsay Duval McEckern. John R. McGrath. Alexandra Diane McRogan. Jackson McIntyre. Sean McLaughlin. Patrick S. McMahon. Kevin Matthew McNally. Grace Mello. Isabel Callianne Messor. Chad Evan Myers. Talia Galley Micucci. Caitlin Alyssa Miller. Maxwell Alexander Miller. Praniti Mirani. Yevgenia Mirmanova. Imani Mobley. Megan Monahan. Nahemi Mondier. Jake Adam Mannheimer. Guillermo Francisco Montalvo. John Cram Morin. David Patrick Morganelli. Jordan Alexis Morris. Mariana Mercado Berlingueri. Michael S. Motisi. Jillian Renee Mountford. Alex Movsesian. Pedro Julio Moya Arisa. John David Moyer. Andrew Stephen Mugford. Artyom Mukhambetov. Ingrid Catherine Murphy. Jordan Elizabeth Needle. Jacob Nasisi. Devin Schuyler Neary. Ryan Neeser. Matthew J. Nekoroski. Blossom Ng.
Chung Ng.
Car Young Kenny Ng. Skylar Trang Nguyen. James Phuc Nguyen. Liz Nguyen. Ang Nguyen. Aaron Notashani. Catherine Nicole Noftal. Devante Nurse. Michael Christopher O'Connell. Colleen Elizabeth O'Connor. Sean Matthew O'Connor. Richard Carl Offenberg. Charles William Ogletree. Anton Oleshko. Jacqueline Elizabeth Oliver. Nicholas William Onder. Alexandra Ross O'Neill. Pearl Anedu Opara. Cade Christopher O'Reilly. Jose Angel Ortega Casares. Yarelis Ortiz. Angie Ortiz Miranda. Kelsey Taylor O'Sullivan. Ji Xuan O. Bianca Joanne Willette. William Suhail Ozone. Diego Pardilla. Esther Park. Allison Mary Parker. Wyatt Parsons. Ashi Sanjay Patel. Anusha Patel. George Pav. TJ Pavone. Ashley Charlotte Peck. Kyle Pelletier. Victoria Ann Pembroke. Alakia Penumarthy. Andres Eduardo Perdomo. Shuhan Lee. Dominique Perez Torres. Matthew James Perron. Chandler Tillman Perry. Aaron Jacob Pessin. Olivia Peterson. Samantha Mackenzie Pito. Caleb James Petty. Alexandra Pizana. Brian Pham. Jeff Tay Geoffrey Guillaume. Lisa Fan. Alexis Mary Philippides. Dane Thomas Phippen. Curtis Joseph Pietro Paolo. Lindsay Pincus. Eric Winston Pitney. Camila Perez. Brendan T. Pingelski. Luca S. Pirondini. Calvin Lewis Palacek. Jared Joseph Potoski. Brian Christopher Powers. Maxwell Gordon Proctor. Samuel H. Lanceman. Liu Jiazi Shin. Han Zhang. J. A. Pruthi. Norman Alberto Killikini Bracco. Pranai Rai. Akash Darshan Rana. Dhruva Rangan.
Yusuf Rashad.
Garrett Patrick Rebholz. Leah Redman. Matthew Richards. Matthew Joseph Ricker. Gabriela Cristina Rivera Rivera. Stephen William Rizzuto. Savona Race Roberts. William Joseph Roberts. Grant Stephen Robinson. Zoe Jean Rocha. Taylor Rochette. Ashley Nicole Rodhouse.
Ernie Rodriguez.
Ricardo Fernando Rodriguez. Maria Alejandra Rodriguez de la Roca. McKenna Romagnano.
Rohan Romeo Garcia Sayan.
Isabella Lee Rangioni. Kathleen Laura Rooney. Maeve Sheila Rooney. Maya Elizabeth Rose. Austin Ross. Nathan Rowe. Kevin Rukai. Mackenzie Teresa Ryan. Logan Davis Sable. Brandon Safranik. Kelly Crystal Saldana. Miguel Angel Sanchez Escobar. Tatiana Monique Sanchez. Araceli Sandoval. Andrew John Sartori. Alyssa Saunders. Scott Davidson Sawyer. Gianna Rose Scalia. Jolie Gail Schmidt. Rebecca Schrager. Duncan Scott. Morgan Scott. Thomas Patrick Seeger. Juliana Cerna. Alexander Monks Sarau. Matthew Michael Severance. Grant J. Shaw. Rishi Kher Shah, Rahi Nimesh Shah, Samira B. Shah, Rolan Shao, Wasif Ahmed Shaman, Brian Ilya Shea, Connor James Sheehan, David Isaac Sheffett, Connor Sheridan, Atmik Sheth, Mitchell Shevchenko, Liliana Silva, Mataus Silva Gino, Emily Rose Singer, Michael Edward Simonelli, Triana Skaridis, Madison Page Slattery, John Howard Slocum III, Chloe Elizabeth Smith, Hannah Susan Smith, Jared Michael Smith, Owen Smith, Samuel Christopher Smith, Karen Dominique Soares, Jordan Seufer, Shedden Salah Solomon, Jonathan Thomas Salamini, Justin Anthony Sorabella, Matthew Spiegel, Guy Springer, Jordan Sproul, Arushi Srivastava, Cambria Shea St. Germain, Leah Elizabeth Stalker, Alexander Starovoitov, Jack Stewart, Zachary George Stewart, Chantel Rena Suero, Albert Joseph Chagrou, Mackenzie Aaron Sullivan, William Francis Sullivan, Hao Yan Sun, Cassidy Jean Susie, Ryan Anthony Svopa, Haley Lynn Swan, Max Swanson, Christopher Carl Sweeney, Joseph Sweeney, Samantha Catherine Sylvester, Kaya Selesky, Bailey Michael Tafner, Oscar Tafoya, Ashley Odette Tala, Jasmine Rose Tunos, Christopher Taranto, Joshua Tejeda, Maria de Lourdes Terran Calderon, Georgia Elena Terry, Nicolette Margaret Tetro, Stefan Thaikul Menendez, Santiago Urrutia Ruiz, Luke Thibault, Eric Thibodeau, Jeremy I. Thomas, Ella Thompson, Mason Thompson, Jacob Michael Tibby, Hunter Ryan Toll, Pearson Tachi, Bryce McKay Tolan, Dariana Gonzalez, Jessica Morley Trahan, Drew Nichols Trouts, Colton James Travis, Gabriella Trevisan Haints, Kelsey Veronica Trevor, Kevin D. Troncoso, Sophia Evelyn Tufankshin, Toline Turkmani, Jake L. Tiska, Meredith Rose Ulrich, Sarah Kamal Uttamsingh, Madison Elizabeth Vadney, Dylan Vaglica, Andres Valerino, Melissa Valucci, Paul Joseph Verano, Cecily Carol Verano, Daniela Vargas, Tejon Vassar, Austin Vino, Vibha Vishwa, Anthony Wiesenthal, Kristen Taylor Balakos, Austin James Vogt, Aiden Jeremy Walker, Sarah Ann Walker, Matthew Sean Walsh, Jared Walter, Marcus Ernest Michael Walter, Lucas Goodman Van Robois, Yingxue Wang, Rosalind Wang, Preston Webb, Wyatt Edward Wegerson, Julia Marie Weinstein, Samantha Kate Weisgold, Aiden Thomas Wierenski, Daniel Wesley, Lauren West, Anna Lynn Weatherby, Kristen Marie White, Lindsay Michelle White, Nicholas Whitefield, Risa Whitehead, Anna Mackenzie Wilcox, Alexa Jacqueline Williams, Julia Marie Williams, Luke Thomas Wininger, Joseph Winkleman, Julia Marie Wisniewski, Lily Evans Woodring, Jake Michael Wozniak, Wei Jun Wu, Sarah Yi Chu Wu, Will Wu, Pei Yu Xia, Chu Yuan Xie, Jay Xu, Maxwell Xu, Alan Yakovi, Tommy Yanbul, Alina Yang, Neil Hao Yang, Zi Ran Yao, Vanessa Saviera Yaputri. Daniel John Yardemian. Cheng An Ye. Ricky Ye. Jaden Xu. Madeline Jane York. Derek Jung. Benjamin David Euculus. Keegan William Youngclaws. Joe Joe. Yu Wei Hong Joe. Emmanuel Kosi Yugu. Mahmoud Yusuf. Justine Y. Zen. Wen Qing Yu. Alina Merrill Zahn. Veronica Cecilia Zamora Colon. Xingjian Kong. Timothy Norman Zupkis.
President Kreit, it is our pleasure and honor to present to you the members of the class of 2023. That's quite a drum roll. They work diligently in the classroom and beyond to secure a Bentley education. With the support of the faculty and trustees of this institution, I am honored to present them to you now.
Candidates. Will the degree candidates please rise and remain standing if able? Your tassel should be on the right side of your cap.
By the authority vested in me by the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. By the common. Try this again. Hold on. All right, let's start this over. By the authority vested in me by the Commonwealth of Massachusetts and the Bentley University Board of Trustees, and by reason of your having fulfilled the requirements prescribed by the faculty and trustees, I proudly pronounce you graduates of Bentley Universities and holders of the degrees indicated with all the related rights, privileges, and responsibilities. Graduates, go forth and join the ranks of Bentley alumni doing remarkable things for their communities. Consequential challenges face us all. Your Bentley degree comes with an opportunity to change the world for the better. Seize the success that awaits you. Congratulations, class of 2023.
Will all new graduates please take the tassel of your cap and move it from the right to the left side? Congratulations to the class of 2023.
Thank you all for joining us here today to both celebrate the achievements and to recognize the potential of the class of 2023. With that, on behalf of the Board of Trustees, Bentley University's 2023 commencement is now concluded.